Here is fast review for Infinix Hot 8. So do not forget to subscribe the channel. The design. Striking, sleek design, with rounded edges and a gradient color back, one of the better looking budget phones around. Offers a good grip, and is relatively lightweight for the size. Both fingerprint reader and face unlock work accurately and quickly. With a large 6.5-inch screen, the phone is a little too big for one-hand usage. The phone has nice display, packs a 6.52-inch HD Plus 720 by 1600 pixels screen with a 20:9 aspect ratio and 90.3% screen to body ratio. Color output is decent, and sunlight legibility is good too. Overall, this is one of the better displays you will see in this price segment. The phone software. XOS UI is a decent Android skin, is smooth to use, and has a few useful features, like the dedicated smart panel, to the left of the home screen for widgets and shortcuts, and intelligence voice broadcast, can read out a lot of things for the user, like cricket scores, news and SMS, as well as personal texts from various messaging apps. It does pack a lot of bloatware, though, and spammy notifications. The phone performance. Decent performance for day-to-day use with a Helio P22, similar to Snapdragon 625, though gaming performance is pretty ordinary, as expected. In terms of overall performance though, the likes of Redmi 7 and Realme 3i fare better, even the lesser RAM variants, because of their faster processors. The phone camera's decent triple camera setup for the price, 13 megapixel primary plus 2 megapixel depth plus low light camera, the primary camera gives reasonably good shots in daylight, sharpness and details are decent, though consistency is an issue. Selfies come out nicely too, but the beauty mode can make the pics look unreal, so it's best turned off. The phone has an excellent battery life with a 5000 mAh battery. You should get a comfortable 2 days of use, decent charging speed, but it's not fast charge though. The Hot 8 is another reliable budget choice from Infinix, offering a good specs to price ratio, allowing it to stand up to tough competition from Xiaomi and Realme. As long as performance is not a major concern, and you are not into gaming, it's worth considering. Yeah,